coming out right in time, maybe just a little bit better than it should. So my preamp noise figure, I think, is a little better than I had modeled it at. We should talk sometime. I can take a look at your system and see if there's anything we can do with a low noise amplifier and improve it there. I see, a lot of difference between rigs and some of the differences between them can be subtle and some of them can be fundamental. So, we should talk more about that, what we might be able to do to improve yours. Tell me a little bit more about the internal architecture of it. I think we had the conversation before when you were having some feed line issues, but after, remind me of all that. And perhaps we should meet over at the Grafton Mall at some point and do some experimenting. The thing that you guys got going for you over there is you have a beacon that you can listen for and do some comparison with. And that would be a good exercise to do. So, with that, thanks, 7-3. Good to talk. And we'll catch up with you a little bit later. I'll let you know how things go out here and pass along any information I can about what's going to be at least the operations from out here. 7-3 for now, K2AEP, WB2BYP.
Okay, very good, John. Just on a last note, several years ago I bought a low noise preamp from Pyro Joe and installed it into the system. It did not help things much at all. It brought the noise floor up, but as far as signal performance, it did not. So I took it out of the system. It was not aiding things at all. I will say it was hindering. So that just somewhere in the collection here. But randomly put my hand on it, but with some searching I couldn't. So yep. The other thing is the Gronach beacon was turned on Saturday morning around 10:30, which was good, and a lot of fellows used that later in the day, and also on Sunday. It was a great help to a lot of people because we were getting asked in the early morning if the beacon was on because guys were not hearing it. So these things are a great reference for so many people. Talk to you later, WB2BYP, K2AEP Cliff.
All right, Pete, very good. 7-3, WB2BYP.
K2AEP, this is Nancy Free, Charlie Mike.
I think it's an N2, Charlie Mike, go ahead.
Nancy 3, Charlie Mike. Nancy 3, Charlie Mike. The name is Dave, I'm over in Western Pennsylvania. What's the speed line for 75 miles south of Erie?
Okay, very good. Well, you're doing quite well, Dave. My name is Pete. I'm up here in South Central Vermont. Using a Transworld TW100 suitcase radio and just a G5RV. Howard?
Okay. Yeah, the radio here is a iPhone 7410. Got a dive to up about 50 feet in depth.
Okay. Well, you're doing quite well. The band is noisy. We're getting a lot of static crashing, etc. But you're riding above it, Howard.
Yeah, this is the first time this summer I've been able to get on. The weather down here is just absolutely gorgeous. There's not a cloud in the sky. It's a chilly system. And it actually feels like October. But like I said, this is the first time really this summer I've got on because the band has just been horrendous looking up. Now, I get some crashing, but you're well over it. Nice to go on you and the other gentlemen are well over the static.
Yeah, that's the funny part about 60 meters that we have been finding in the past several weeks is the noise floor is really crunchy, but signals are certainly riding well above it, which is good to be able to use this stuff in the summer. John and I were just talking about the 10 gigahertz microwave contest that was taking place this past weekend and how well we did. And we didn't have great propagation, but some rather interesting enhancement that improved signals. But there was a lot of obstruction with all these rain clouds and a lot of the strange weather that was going on out here. Had a beautiful day today. I went kayaking with a lady friend of up on this lake where we were kayaking and made a little tough dive of home. N3CM from K2AET.
Okay, hey, Pete, here, give me a little, I'm not at all familiar with Vermont. Just like most people. Kind of give me a clue where Vermont is located. Never tried it. Too clumsy, too awkward. I'd probably kill the first.